I'm going to cross live to Israel in just a moment for an update on the ground, but this frustrates me to no end, but Anthony Albanese has basically spoken publicly directly to Netanyahu. We've heard from Penny Wong, but have a listen to what Albanese has said.
Well, I say to Prime Minister Netanyahu that he needs to listen to the international community, just like the other players in that region need to listen to the international community. The calls are very clear. We are very concerned, and the world is concerned, about the escalation that is continuing here and the consequences for it.
War has rules, even when confronting terrorists, even when defending borders, civilians need to be protected. But in conflicts around the world, this is not happening. Nearly a year ago, Hamas killed 1,200 Israelis. In Israel's response, over 40,000 Palestinians have been killed, more than 11,000 children.
Now, all of this is horrific. We all know that. There's nobody who wants this to escalate or wants kids to die. Nobody. But for Albanese to single out Netanyahu by name in a public address, telling him to stop, where's the leader of Hezbollah? Where's the name check for Hamas? Where's the name check for Iran? This blows my mind.
Well, I'd say two things to this, Erin. Prime Minister Albanese calls out Netanyahu by name in a press conference in front of cameras, but didn't have the guts to call Prime Minister Netanyahu himself, who was in New York at the UN right now. So I think that's a little bit gutless. The second point I would make is that Prime Minister Albanese starts talking about the international community, you know, doesn't want you to do this. Well, it's not the international community that is coming to Israel's aid.
Exactly.
It's not the international communities whose children are being killed by terrorists, you know, on a massive scale. It's not the international community that has to suffer constant terrorism and attacks on their civilians every day, and therefore Israel has the right to defend itself.
I was at this event last night, Link, and this lovely lady said to me, the Iron Dome is incredible for Israel. Think of the casualty if it didn't exist. But the PR that they lose by having that Iron Dome and protecting their citizens is enormous. The cost of it is enormous. We're not seeing the images out of Israel that we would with all the bombs going in because they can protect themselves.
Right.
They're being punished for protecting themselves and then for going after the aggressors.
It's insane. He's trying to simplify a very complex issue and put it into a very convenient soundbite, which I don't think is fair. I don't think it's statesmanlike, and it shouldn't be coming out of the mouths of the so-called partner of Australia and the Prime Minister of Australia.
It's like when President Biden said that Netanyahu wasn't doing enough. His first public response to six, including one American Israeli hostage being shot. And that was his first comment publicly. Netanyahu's not doing enough.
It shows a stunning lack of balance.
Yeah, no, it really does. Link, thank you very much. Really appreciate your time, as always.